Hello and welcome to another episode of In Conversation. My name is Bongani Mncube, and as we've been posting on our socials, we have opened up the conversation. Be free to send through questions to every guest that we are going to be having in studio. Of course, we are UJTV 23 on all social media platforms. Without further ado, today I'm joined in studio by the Director of School of Management, Prof. Adri Drotskie. Prof, welcome to the show.
Thank you very much.
Yes, Prof.
Well, pleasure to be here.
No, definitely, definitely. We want to know more about the School of Management. I think that is us today. Firstly, Prof, where are you? Where is the School of Management located? I think start likely there.
So the School of Management is part of the College of Business and Economics,
yes.
And there's six schools in the college,
mm-hmm.
And School of Management is one of them.
Yes.
And we are quite a large school. We have about 11,000 students in the school and about 260 staff members. So some people refer to us as our almost a university on our own, but mm-hmm. It is just it's one of the schools in the college,
mm-hmm.
and it consists of four departments.
Mm-hmm.
So the Department of Business Management,
yes.
Department of Finance and Investment Management, Industrial Psychology and People Management,
yes.
and Transport and Supply Chain Management.
Wow.
Those four departments make up the School of Management.
And in an overview perspective, what are some of the key objectives and initiatives that the school is focusing on?
Our purpose,
yes.
and our positioning that we have as a
Indeed.
School is that we want to focus on education excellence,
yes.
and societal impact.
Yes.
And we do that through innovative and creative learning and research,
yes.
In the context of management competence. So management competence is
yes.
our speciality.
Oh.
So all of these departments that we have in the school,
yes.
they focus on different aspects of okay. management.
Mm-hmm.
And we do that to create a sustainable work and life for mm-hmm. students.
For students, yeah.
So that they can be prepared for anything that they go and do outside.
Yes.
Management is always somewhere in the equation.
Indeed.
You might not be a manager when you start working,
yes.
but you have to manage your life to start with.
Mm.
So we have this as our purpose and our positioning.
Yes.
And one of the things that we really set as an objective in the school is mm-hmm. that we would like to create whole people, whole students.
Wow.
So we don't only want them to leave with a certificate
yes.
or a degree in their hand.
Yes.
They must have life skills.
Indeed.
They must be streetwise when they leave us. And therefore, we also offer them other skills like
yes.
financial literacy and career planning and
yes.
how do I prepare myself to now go out there and find a job.
A job.
And also how to make a societal impact. So we put a lot of focus on what do you do outside your normal studying. To also contribute towards your society, the community that you are in.
And that aligns with I think, the university goals for
yes.
community development. And Prof, well, I just also want to touch on what are some of the careers that are coming out of the school, maybe? I know management is broad, but what are some of the key careers that you are witnessing from the school?
So the people who do general business management,
yes.
They go into any big corporate,
yes.
but they also, we have small business as a major that
yes.
you can take. We also have a lot of focus on entrepreneurship.
Yes.
So a lot of people leave here and they can start their own business.
Mm.
So that is quite a big focus for us.
Yes.
Then we have the financial side
mm-hmm.
where we train people in financial planning
yes.
And in investment management. And that is mainly in the financial services.
Yes.
We try to get them accredited
yes.
with the professional bodies.
Mm.
We also have property management
yes.
Where we train valuers
yes.
who can do property valuations.
Mm.
On the people management side, we get professional or accredited industrial psychologists.
Okay.
who then specialize in that field.
Yes.
People who are just HR specialists,
yes.
They work with all the people management in any mm-hmm. organization.
Yes.
And then on the transport and supply chain side, that is a very specialist field these yes. days, with logistics management, supply chain mm-hmm. management, which more and more organizations
yes.
Have a need for. So you can specialize in all those different fields.
Yes. And to produce people that are actually going into those fields, I think, as the school prides itself in the relationship between the staff and the students. Just please take me through that process. I know you guys have a unique process that you have in terms of a good environment and productive environment between students and staff.
Yes, yes. I believe in the principle of a staff experience
yes.
leads to a customer experience or then our student experience. I did my own PhD in customer experience,
wow.
and that led to this one finding in my studies.
Yes.
And I find it very interesting that you can actually apply it anywhere.
Mm-hmm.
But what it really comes down to is mm-hmm. if staff are happy,
yes.
And they have a good work environment,
yes.
They're getting rewarded for what they do,
mm-hmm.
they feel passionate mm-hmm. about what they do,
yes.
then it automatically flows mm. to the students who sit in front of them. You cannot really change the student experience mm. literally,
yes.
but if the staff come and they show this enthusiasm
yes.
and they are experts in what they do,
indeed.
And they have great knowledge on what they are teaching,
yes.
Then it automatically makes the students feel, I'm getting value out of this.
Indeed.
You know, they are really giving mm. me something that makes me passionate as
yes,
well.
Yes, worth
as
for
a
my
student.
Money.
Yes,
and even
yes.
the education becomes different.
No, absolutely.
And adding to that, I as part of the key objectives which we're going to attach that are set by the school this year, it's is education itself from
yes.
both the students and staff.
Yes.
Can you please take me through that? I know some encouraging staff to actually also attain their PhDs or improve their education.
Yes, we put a lot of emphasis on that, and we want our staff to be lifelong learners,
yes.
and they continuously studying and doing short courses. We offer them additional courses.
Yes.
Also in the college, there's a lot of opportunity to learn new skills. I think after COVID, we all got a new set of skills on teaching online and
yes.
all of these new ways of teaching.
Of teaching, yes.
But I think it's important that the staff must also feel that they don't stagnate. They are also on top of the latest that's happening in their field,
mm-hmm.
specifically in management, because you know, we must know what's happening in industry.
Indeed.
We must know what's happening in business.
Yes.
So we have close collaborations with industry,
mm-hmm.
And we try to find out what their needs are,
yes.
so that our staff can also experience what is happening,
what is happening
in the practice,
yes.
So that they can apply that when it goes to the students.
Mm-hmm.
So we also, as you mentioned, we try to get all our staff to get to PhDs.
Yes.
And through the PhDs, we also find that there's a very close relationship between research and teaching.
Mm.
So while you are doing your studies,
yes.
you do a lot of research.
Indeed.
But through the research, you find new things.
Mm.
And those things you then go and apply in your classroom.
Yes.
And you teach that to the students.
Hmm.
And in the classroom, you find that students ask questions and they want to know new things.
Mm-hmm.
And that takes you back to your research again. So there's a very big correlation between those two things.
I never thought it like that. It really sounds amazing when you put it like that. And given the practical sense that, of the principle that you have, which you also discovered within your research.
Yes.
That's really an amazing one, Prof. Well, I also like to touch on the collaborations that the school has, some of the key notable relationships, whether the industry and internally. What are some of those?
Yes, we have a lot of relationships, as I said, with corporates.
Yes.
We also have collaborations with like the CETAs. Mm-hmm. We work very closely with them. Yes. And then all these professional bodies where our students get registered.
Yes.
We have to keep very good relationships with them. Indeed. They also come to us regularly and come and do a review and see if we're still teaching them the right things and yes. the standards are there and the quality. So those are also very good relationships.
Yes.
Then we also have big relationships with other universities. We try to collaborate with them. The whole notion of multidisciplinary research, we try to do research with other people in our field of expertise.
Yes.
And we also do it internally. We have a lot of collaboration with the other faculties in UJ,
yes.
other departments in the college, other schools,
yes.
so that we can make sure that we keep up to what happens in all the fields.
Mm-hmm.
There's very few areas or fields of study these days
yes.
that are not multidisciplinary.
Indeed.
You know, the world we live in is too complex.
It's too complex.
You cannot focus on one little thing and think that's the only thing that's going to help you.
Yes.
You have to touch on everything in this complexity, the system
yes.
that's going to impact on each other.
Indeed.
So we really put a lot of focus on collaboration.
On collaboration.
Yes.
And, well, as the numbers don't lie, over plus or minus students that you have, what makes the School of Management the choice? What are you guys having there that is so amazing? Just the uniqueness, just want to find the unique selling point.
I think one of the things is that it's very established departments.
Yes.
Most of them have been there, like transport and supply chain was established in the 1970s.
Wow.
You know, it's very, very established department.
Yes.
So it's been coming a long way.
Yes.
It's got a very good reputation.
Mm.
And with the students coming into UJ
yes.
and the majority of students that we want to give the opportunity to study,
yes.
They have there in one school all the different parts of management
yes.
that they can choose from.
Mm.
So I think it's a combination of that it's got a good reputation.
Yes.
We have students that complete their studies, they graduate successfully. And also it's word of mouth a lot
yes.
because these people go out into business and they say to other students, you know, if you want to do this degree, go to UJ.
Yes.
You'll find it there in the School of Management. So it's a lot of word of mouth.
It's a lot of word of mouth.
Yes. And also to keep up to speed with what the latest needs are, as I
yes.
mentioned.
Mm-hmm.
We have, for example, launched a Master of Sustainability Management last year.
Oh, yeah.
And we found that in the world out there, sustainability is the new buzzword.
Indeed.
It's also part of UJ's new strategy that's coming in 2035. And we want to train people to really get there. And it's interesting, the people we've got in the class at the moment,
yes.
you know, I get calls from people, this guy told me he's doing this degree with you, when can we do it? You know, so it's really people speaking to each other. But then you must have the right quality and
yes.
you must give a good program.
Exactly.
Otherwise, you get the opposite.
Indeed.
Yes.
Because now for a person to actually tell a different person, it's because they are happy with the quality
yeah.
that they're
yeah.
receiving. Wow. And Prof, touching on the strategies, can you share some with us some of the key strategies that the department has, that the school has for this year?
So we have a very big focus on the student experience.
Yes.
So the plans that we have there is that we communicate with our students regularly.
Yes.
Every year in about October, we do some focus groups with the students in the classes
yes.
where we ask them what worked for you this year, what can we change.
Yes.
So we listen to the voice of the student and we really then put new things in place. We want to take the financial literacy program further.
Yes.
It's a program that we developed in in the school.
Yes.
And it's open for everybody in UJ. Oh. It's for free. You can do, it's called Be Money Wise.
Oh.
And it gives you basic literacy skills. Yes. We want all our students to leave here with that skill.
Yes.
Then on our postgrad side, we have a lot of networking and a lot of working together of the master's and doctorate students.
Yes.
Because that's a lonely journey if you do those studies. And we really want them to work in networks and assist each other.
Assist each other.
Then on the research side, we set ourselves a goal of how much research output we want for a year.
Wow.
But we also have a lot of research workshops where we invite the students as well as the supervisors.
Yes.
And we also keep them up to date with the latest in research.
Yes.
Then we also have a big societal impact focus.
Mm-hmm.
We do a lot of community work.
Yes.
The school started last year with a big community project at the Rahima Musa Mother and Child Hospital, just down the road here. And we collected baby clothes and things for babies from our students, from our staff, and ended up with boxes and boxes full of clothes that we took to them. And so we want the students to also be involved in the society. And we also have a very big focus on our academic integrity.
Yes.
That's a big strategy in the school.
Yes.
So every year, twice a year for a month, we have an academic integrity month where we want to entrench values of being ethical and have academic integrity in everything you do in all our students.
Mm.
So we work closely with the library and we have speakers. We get the students together to look at academic integrity.
Yes.
And that's, I think, more or less the biggest things that we focus on.
Which are very important, are very important, Prof. And it was leading me to my actual next question, which speaks on ethical leadership and sustainability.
Mm.
I can imagine if you are into management, you're supposed to have ethical leadership qualities.
Absolutely.
Can we touch on the importance of this a little bit more, the importance of ethical leadership and sustainability?
I think ethical leadership is something that we teach the students about what it is, but it won't help if they cannot apply it practically.
Indeed.
And I think where we are at as a country at the moment, there's a lot of questions, things we see every day in the news on ethics.
Yes.
So I think it's our duty to really entrench that in everything we do.
Yes.
So it's not only a course that you do in leadership.
Mm.
We have to train people to become ethical leaders and to see what the benefits of it are.
Yes.
Because we get a lot of students who tell us, also with the academic integrity, which is very close to that, they say to us, but why must I do this if nobody else around me is doing it? What's the benefit in it?
What's the benefit in it? Yes.
And I just think that if you have to live with your own conscience, and you can say at the end of your studies that I've really done this well, and I've done this, in a ethical manner.
Yes.
You have achieved more than doing it in an unethical way, and you must always look behind you, who's going to find out. And, so I think ethics is something that needs to be entrenched in everything we do.
Indeed.
And then it will flow over into the community and organizations that there is value in having ethical leadership.
Indeed, I think.
And on the sustainability side, that is a very big focus for us because it is a critical part of business these days. So we are at the moment busy developing short learning programs for the corporates that all their staff can understand what is sustainability. the SDGs, the ESG, all of these new terms that's come into play, we need to start training people in that field.
Yes, yes. And I liked also to, on the ethical leadership side, it has actually led to some achievements within the department.
As
I was seeing that Dr. Tsekhofatso Mabitsela, the industrials.
Yes.
And what are some of the achievements that have came out, more inspirational stories from the school itself?
I think the what's amazing for us is if we have alumni of the school and we then see them growing in their positions,
indeed.
You know, and they become the chairperson of a board of a company, you know, or they achieve something in their own businesses even, and they become prominent ethical business people.
Yes.
And we know that they got their education from us.
That's cool.
So that for us is very important.
Very important.
And we've got quite a number of these people already.
Yes.
We also let them come back and speak to the students, you know, and tell their stories so that we can learn from that.
And that becomes more inspirational. Imagine
having
your heroes right in front of you and a person from the same institution, the same position that the student was in once upon a time.
No, absolutely.
Oh, it is quite impressive. Well, Prof, I just also want to find out the long-term vision and legacy. As you mentioned, some of the projects that you're doing with the community from Rahima Musa and other places. What legacy do you hope to leave through these initiatives?
Well, I think we want to really become practical.
Yeah.
That, as I said now, that you can see people in big positions and they tell, but I studied at UJ in that school. That's where I learned about this. And then to make a difference in the society. We've got a very big initiative, I haven't mentioned it yet, is in Daba Zokudla on the Soweto campus, where we, it's part of the Small Business and Entrepreneurship Department, but they have, they train farmers, emerging farmers, farm workers, and they come in vast numbers on Saturday mornings and we train them in basic management skills.
Yes.
Because whether you are a emerging farmer or you do whatever, you have to know the basic skills.
Mm.
So we try to put a footprint in all the industries.
Yes.
You know, we don't want to be seen as we're only there for the big corporates.
Exactly.
We want to be there for the whole society and leave a footprint.
Mm.
And do it in a sustainable way.
Yes.
They mustn't forget about it tomorrow. It must stay with them forever.
It's important. That becomes a legacy, actually, on its own.
Exactly, yeah.
Indeed, Prof. And, well, I just also want to find out, because innovation is key to staying ahead in your field particularly. Mm-hmm. How is the school managing that? How are you keeping ahead of the trends and being innovative at the same time?
Well, we try to bring in innovative ways of teaching. We try to make it as practical as possible. We take the students to the place where things happen instead of them just sitting in a classroom. We've got a lot of innovations on the technology side, apps that's been developed in the school for the students to use, quick ways of getting to information, the way the youngsters do these days. And we also have in one of our departments, we have creativity and design as a very strong focus.
Yes.
So we've got an innovation and creativity week coming up now very soon, which we run with that every year. And it's a world conference that we have here in South Africa.
Wow.
So we try to keep up to date with all the new new trends.
So
that people can start applying that.
Exactly, yeah.
Too. And we also need to be on top of what where our students are.
Yes.
You know, they're a different generation than we are.
True.
So we need to know what are the new innovations. What do they find interesting?
Yes.
Because we need to capture their attention and really give them something that's of value.
Yes.
So innovation is very high up on our priorities.
Priorities, indeed, indeed. Well, Prof, we're almost at the end of our interview, but I would also just, I'll just open up the platform in case a message to any student that is out there, a person that is actually trying to find out more about the school, what it does, and wants to be part of the school, and the current students that you have in the school, just a word of motivation, a word of advice. So, you know, lately, the new generation says word of the day.
So, word of the day.
Word of the day.
Yeah, I think to the students out there, I think you need to be on top of what's happening around you. You have to keep on learning.
Yes.
Never stop learning. Learn, lifelong learning.
Yes.
That's a big thing.
Yes.
And I think you need to find something to do that is also fun.
Yes.
And that you like doing. Don't just go and study something because I have to. You know, my
option.
Mom and dad said I must do this and this. You know, I heard of this and this.
Yes.
Go and find that thing that's going to inspire you and that you are going to really enjoy doing.
Yes.
Because if there's not fun in it, then you're going to battle. And you must make it your own.
Yes.
And you must go and apply it out there and really make a difference in the world around you.
Mm. That is very powerful. That is the word of the day. Go and make a difference in the world. Well, Prof, thank you so much. And my last question would be, where can they access maybe the school information, more about the school online website?
They can go to SOM,
yes.
School of Management,
okay.
at UJ.
Yes.
Our biggest platform is LinkedIn.
LinkedIn, okay.
So we have a very active page on LinkedIn.
Yes.
Some of the departments are also on Facebook, on Twitter.
Yes.
But, X, sorry.
yes.
LinkedIn is our big, big page.
Yes.
It is SOM. At UJ.
Yes.
There you can find all the information about the school and what we are busy with and what you can come and study and where to find more information about the school.
Definitely. Well, there you have it, dear viewers. This was my conversation with Prof. Adri Drotskie to tell us more about the School of Management. Prof, again, thank you so much for joining me.
Thank you. It was my pleasure.
Yes.
Thank you.
Well, see you on the next episode, guys. Thank you so much for tuning in.
The University of Johannesburg, the future reimagined.